In this video, I am going to explain you how to do the isometric projections or isometric component for the given orthographic projections. This is the orthographic projection, that is 2D drawing. This is the front view and this is the top view of the component. In the top view, we can see all the circles, but in the front view, we can see only horizontal and vertical lines. So this component is in circular shape. Okay, so first let us concentrate on the diameters of these circles. See, this is the external diameter of the circle. Okay, this is the external circle of diameter 140 mm, and we can see here one more circle, but this is a reference circle for this 4 holes of diameter 10 mm drills. Okay, so this diameter of the circle is 100 mm. So forget about this 100 mm, we will do in the next step. Next, one more circle here. This circle diameter is given in the mentioned in the front view, that is diameter 70 mm. And one more hidden line we can see here. So this hidden line diameter of this is 60 mm, 140, 70 and 60 mm. We can do in SolidWorks this component in two ways. One is by using circle command, one more by using by drawing the center line, and with the help of this revolve base command, with the help of this revolve base command, we can do this isometric component. In this video, I will show you the both the methods. Using circular method, how we can obtain this isometric object. Let us see. Select new file, select new part file. Here external diameter is 140 mm, of height 20 mm. This is the top view. Okay, here select top plane, select top view, select sketch, select circle command. From origin point, draw one circle, sketch, select dimension. The dimensioning of this circle, the diameter of the out circle is 140 mm, diameter of the outer circle is 140 mm. Enter 140 and select OK. Now select isometric view. Height is 20 mm. Select extruded base, enter 20 mm, select OK. So this is the base of this isometric component. Next, height of 70 mm, of diameter 70. So draw one more circle on this top of the base of diameter 70 mm circle and extrude a height of 70 mm. Select top face, select top view, select sketch, select circle command. From origin point, draw one circle, make dimension, diameter of this circle 70 mm, isometric, extruded base, 70 mm, height of the circle diameter 70 is 70 mm, height is 70 mm, enter 70 and select OK. Now select this top face followed by top view, sketch, circle. From origin point, draw one more circle. Make dimension. You can see hidden line here. So this diameter, this circle can be seen 60 mm. Diameter of this circle is 60 mm. Select isometric view. Here we have to cut this geometrical shape, okay, through all. Extrude cut. Here instead of blind, select through all, okay, and select OK. In this figure we can see that 4 holes of diameter 10 mm drill. This circle is 100 mm. Select this top face, top view, sketch, select circle. From origin point, draw one circle. Make dimension. Diameter of this circle is 100 mm. Take a circle command. Draw a circle. All the four sides. Make dimension. Diameter of this circles 10 mm. Enter 10. Now make it center. Select extrude cut. So before that we have to trim this circle. Oh. Diameter 100 mm. Okay, extrude cut, select through all and select OK. So this is the component as per the given dimension. I will explain one more method. So in front view we can see one center line, okay, only see the off portion of the sketch, okay, leave it the off sketch, only see the off portion of the sketch, right side of the sketch from the center line. See, we can see one from bottom. Draw one center line followed by from this end. Draw one horizontal line, vertical, horizontal, vertical, and horizontal. Only external diameters, okay, external dimension. Select sketch, select center line command. From origin point, draw one vertical line. Okay, here draw one vertical line. Make dimension, height of this length, center line, 20 plus 70 mm. Next, take a line command. Center line and this is a line command, okay. From origin point, draw an horizontal line. See, approx this diameter is 140 mm. So off of 140 is 70 mm. So draw approx 70 mm line followed by height 20, approx 20 mm. Again draw an horizontal line, vertical line up to this end. Again draw one line. Make dimension, Here we have to give only radius because we are taking only half portion. Length is 140 divided by 2. Here diameter is 70. So 70 divided by 2 is 35. 35. Height, base height is 20 and height from ear to ear is 70. Enter 20 mm followed by 70. So it will be 70 mm because length is 90. 90 minus 20 is 70. Okay. Next, take line command. See, we can see one more hidden line here. One more circle of diameter 60 mm. So draw one line, make dimension center line to this vertical line 60 divided by 2. Okay, next select sketch trim. Because this is a hollow portion. This is a hollow portion. This diameter 60 is there, no? This is the hollow portion. So we have to trim this both horizontal lines. Trim this horizontal line. Here we can see beside of extruded base and extruded cut, we can see revolve base command. Okay. Select revolve base. Obtain this isometric object. Now select this top face followed by top view. Select sketch. Take center line command from this origin point reference line. Draw one center line horizontally. Inside, and from this horizontal reference line, draw one more line like this. Next, take circle command exactly on this center line. Draw the four circles this way. Make dimension of these circle. 10 mm diameter. Enter 10 mm. All the four circles. Enter 10 mm. Do the dimensions now. From this center point to this circle, it will be 50 mm because here he has mentioned diameter of this circle where the four walls of diameter 10 mm has been placed is 100 mm. So radius will be 50. So enter 50 mm from this origin point to this circle. 50. Okay, do the dimensions in this way. 50. Straight cut and select through all. Select OK. This is as per the given dimension. Do the dimensioning. Select dimension. okay, do all the dimensions which this